वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू आवर चैप्टर नंबर 8, आवर स्केलेटल सिस्टम एंड द स्किन पार्ट 3. इन द प्रीवियस पार्ट्स वी आर फिनिश्ड विल स्केलेटल सिस्टम. टुडे लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द स्किन. चिल्ड्रन, बिफोर दैट दे आर आस्किंग, कैन यू रिकॉल विच ऑर्गन हेल्प्स अस टू सेंस वेदर समथिंग इज हॉट और कोल्ड, रफ और स्मूथ एक्सेट्रा. यू नो वेरी वेल चिल्ड्रन, दैट इज द स्किन. Skin is one of our sensory organ which helps us to know whether the thing is hot or cold, rough or smooth. You know that there are 5 sensory organs. Out of that, skin is one of the important sensory organs which helps us to sense whether the things are hot or cold. Before that, here there are some functions of the skin, children. Let us see. First one, protecting the internal parts of the body like muscles, bones, organ systems, etc. You all know, children, skin protects our all the internal organs, internal parts of our body. Okay, muscles, bones, organ systems, etc. Second, it helps to prevent the moisture in the body. Moisture, it does not prevent the loss of water from our body. That is, moisture is prevent in our body. Third, synthesizing vitamin D. Vitamin D is very important for our skin, children. So producing, synthesizing means producing vitamin D. It is very important for our skin, and that is the function of the skin. It helps in the production of vitamin D. Fourth thing, it releases sweat to regulate our body temperature. Children, you know, in the summer season you sweat a lot, yes or no children? But releasing sweat is very important, because due to that sweat, helps in releasing the sweat from our body. That only helps to regulate your body temperature. You all know that our body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. In summer, what happens? The temperature is very high. So what happens? Body temperature also rises. To maintain our body temperature till 37 degrees Celsius, it releases sweat from our body. And that is the function of the skin. Fifth one is giving protection from heat and cold, children. Skin does very important function, that it gives protection from heat also and from cold also. Sixth important function, the skin functions as a sensory organ. You all know, skin is one of our one of the important sensory organs. Out of the 5 sensory organs, it helps us to know whether the things are hot or cold. We can come to know whether the things are hot or cold, rough or smooth, by touching only, and that touching means sense it is given by the skin. So these are some of the 6 important functions of the skin. Now let us study in detail about the skin. What is skin, children? The skin is an important and large organ of all living things. It is counted as one of the organ only. It covers all our body from head to toe. Yes or no? So it is, skin has hair. On skin you have small hairs, children. On your hands, on your legs, yes or no? They are for protection only. There are nails on the skin at the tips of fingers and toes. Yes or no, children? On the hands you will have what? Fingers you have nails. On the toes you have nails. The skin gives a sense of touch, as it is one of the sensory organ. The skin is an important sensory organ of the body. So children, what is the function of the skin? Skin is nothing but it is the outermost covering of the body. Yes or no, children? Whatever you look outside, like you put a cover of plastic to your books. So that outer covering is of plastic. Similarly, our bodies, outer covering is nothing but it is the skin. It is the outermost covering of our body, that is called as a skin. So these are the 6 important functions, very important. What is skin? Skin is nothing but it is outermost covering of the body. Now let's move further and see structure of the skin. Very important, practice this diagram, structure of the skin. Children, there are 2 important layers out of the skin is made. So human skin is made up of two main layers. This outermost layer in the diagram, can you see? This one is epidermis. This is outermost layer. Okay, and the layer below the epidermis is what? Which layer? This is first layer. The layer below the epidermis is what? Dermis. Below the dermis there is a network of blood vessels and nerve fibers. Children, below the dermis what happens? What are there? There are 2 things, blood vessels and nerve fibers. Blood vessels are nothing but they carry the blood, circulate the blood to our body parts. And nerve fibers, these are the nerve fibers, they are connected from brain to the different parts. yes or no? Below the dermis, there is one more layer, that is subcutis. It is also called as hypodermis. The subcutaneous layer under this network maintains normal body temperature. This has very important function. The subcutaneous layer under this network, what it does? It does maintaining our body temperature. Its function is to maintain the human body temperature to the normal. The epidermis has various layers. So remember this, children, structure of skin. Practice this diagram in your notebook. Very important. Two main layers the skin is made. The outer one is the epidermis. Below that is the dermis. And below the dermis, there is a network of blood vessels and nerve fibers. And one more layer is there, subcutaneous layer. It does the work of maintaining body temperature. Now let's move further. Now, children, we are going to learn about melanin. What is melanin, children? Melanin is nothing but it is a pigment, okay, children, present in the cells of epidermis. And what is the function of this? The melanin is synthesized in certain glands in the skin. Synthesized means it's produced. Where it is produced? By the certain glands which are present in the skin. Melanin is nothing but it is a pigment. It is a color pigment, you can see. Your skin has color, dark color, ekdam fair color. Yes or no? Fair color, dark color. Okay. So melanin decides the color of the skin. The percentage of melanin decides fairness or darkness of the skin. The color of the skin also depends on the climate. Sometimes the people are very dark due to the climate also. You can't say that due to the melanin only, but melanin is a pigment that is deciding the color of the skin, whether the person is a fair or a darker one. Even it is depends on the climate also. Melanin protects our skin and its inner parts of the from ultraviolet rays. Even it does the function of protection of our skin from the harmful ultraviolet rays. Is it okay, children? So melanin is nothing but it is a pigment. It is present in the cells of epidermis. Epidermis is the outermost layer of the skin. Okay, and melanin is produced from the certain glands of the skin. On skin only some glands are there which produces this pigment called melanin, and melanin is responsible for deciding the colorness of the skin, fairness or darkness. Now, children, they are asking, can you tell what happens when we walk or play in the hot sun? What happens, children, when we walk or play in the hot sun? When we walk or play in the sun, we get tired, yes or no? You get tired, but at the same time, our skin becomes wet. This is because of sweat, yes or no, children? After some time you get tired, that is true, but what happens? Your skin becomes wet. Wet means what happens? That is nothing but that is sweat. In the skin there are glands which secrete sweat. And how this sweat comes from your body? Yes or you should know that, because this sweat comes from the sweat glands which are present in your skin only. How the melanin is present? Melanin is produced by the certain glands which are present in the skin only. Similarly, the sweat is also released from the certain glands. That glands are also named as sweat glands only. From the sweat glands, sweat is released. When we do much hard work, play in the hot sun, walk in the hot sun, immediately sweat starts coming from your body, and that comes from sweat glands which are present in the skin only. After playing in the hot sun or after doing hard work, after playing in the hot sun or after hard physical labor, the temperature of the body rises. What happens, children? The temperature of the body rises. Then sweat is released. First, what happens, children? Your temperature of the body rises. Then the sweat starts releasing. Sweat doesn't release as it is. Because you've done some hard work, what happened? Your temperature, you walked in the hot sun. Due to that, body's temperature rised. And then only the sweat is released from your body. It helps to reduce the temperature of the body, but the sweat is good also because it helps to maintain your body temperature, and our body temperature is maintained at 37 degrees Celsius. If it is increased by 37 degrees Celsius, what happens? The sweat is released, and sweat helps to maintain it till 37 degrees Celsius. Use your brain power. Which color of the skin will give greater protection from the sun's rays? Okay. And you have to find out how does sweating help to lower the temperature of the body. The answer is here only. Now let's see further the last part. Observe and discuss. Observe your skin and the skin of your grandmother, grandfather or any old people in your house. Is it same like you all? No. On the old people faces, can you see this line? These are wrinkles. But you don't find wrinkles on this baby's face. Yes or no? A baby's skin is very much tight. Yes or no? What difference do you notice in the baby's skin and the grandmother or grandfather or any old people in your house? As we grow older, what happens, children? The proportion of fat beneath the skin reduces. The proportion of fat, what happens? It reduces. However, the previously taut skin does not shrink. Taut skin means tight skin does not shrink. But what happens due to the fat reduces, that then only what happens? The wrinkles appear on the old people's skin. This causes wrinkles on the skin of the older people. So what is the reason you will give? Why the wrinkles appear? Because the proportion of fat beneath the skin, what it reduces. So this causes wrinkles on the skin of older people. Now children, do you know it is melanin that determines the color of hair? Well, no, melanin is the pigment which decides the color. Even hair's color is decided due to the melanin. Jet black color is due to pure melanin, while brown lighter hair is due to sulfur in the melanin, and reddish hair due to the iron in the melanin. It is due to the presence of different minerals in the melanin, the color of the hairs are different. Always remember, for the health of our skin, it is important to keep it clean. What you should do for the care of the skin, you should keep it clean. Wash your body with nice soap. Okay, discriminating between people based on their skin color is unscientific and wrong. Children, some people are very much fair, some are very dark, but you should not differentiate them on the basis of the color. Okay, you should not tease them. Avoid the temptation of using artificial means to become fair. But some are dark, so they are trying to use artificial things available in the market, cosmetics, to become fair. But you should not use the artificial things to become fair. That is, natural skin should be natural only. Though you are dark, it should remain like that only. You should not try to make it fair by using artificial cosmetics available in the market. So here we end our chapter. In the next part, I will upload this question answers. Till then, revise, read the lesson from your textbook thoroughly.